What happens when the farmers feel they should invent something? Modern machinery might make things easier, however, it can change the very touch that gives taste to some crops. In the case of papaya, farmers cannot just bring machines into the fields and try to increase the yield. Rather, they have to combine their traditional techniques with some next-generation machines to produce the papaya yield. But how are papayas cultivated and harvested? And what about the famous grafting technique that produces healthy and sweet papayas? Welcome back to another exciting episode of our channel. The Mechanicals brings you engineering marvels and little-known farming techniques that are revolutionizing the world in one way or the other. If you are new to the channel but enjoy learning about how technology and innovation are shaping the world's future, you will love to watch the videos we post on this channel. In this video, we will uncover every secret behind papaya cultivation, farming, grafting, harvesting, and processing. Let's get started. Papaya farms are places where the workers ensure the atmosphere is optimum for adequate growth. Hence, the farms are prepared before papaya seedlings can be sown into the fields. It should be noted that papayas have seeds, hence, they can be sown to get little seedlings. Farmers select the best quality papaya seeds to be sown not into the fields directly, but rather into small plastic containers. Each seed will turn into a gigantic tree brimming with hundreds of papayas from top to bottom. Unlike palm trees, where dates are only on the top, papayas trees bring papayas from the top to the bottom of the trees. They might seem like a tree, however, they are heavy stems bringing green and fresh papayas on the wood-like shoots. Let's trace the phases included in papayas cultivation and harvest now. First, seeds would be sown in plastic containers or cut down plastic bottles. These seeds are given sufficient water and nutrients so that they can sprout into little seedlings. Meanwhile, the farmers prepare the fields by plowing and making soil beds so these little seedlings can be planted later. After some time, the seeds in the little plastic container sprout and turn into little plants which can no longer be kept in those small plastic containers. Hence, workers pick these seedlings and plant them into freshly made soil beds. Long rows of papaya seedlings are planted. It should be noted that the seedlings are planted many feet away from each other because they will grow into a tree, not a plant. Once planting has been done, a water system is installed so that the crop can absorb enough water. Nutrients from fertilizers and sprayed minerals are also given to the growing crop. Since papaya plants will grow bigger and turn into trees, they need more water than ordinary crops. It's the water that brings turgidity to the plant cells, allowing the next phase to overtake them. Before we continue further, tell us, are you loving the video? If yes, please like and share the video and subscribe to our channel for more videos where we unveil breathtaking engineering and farming techniques. Let's continue now. When the papaya plants grow and reach the size of 3 to 4 feet, farmers decide whether they should be grafted or not. Grafting is done to ensure plants' resistance against diseases and to preserve their specific characteristics. It's also done to bring in more varieties and make the plants condition to the specific soil environment. However, papaya plants do not essentially need grafting to be done. They will grow and bring papayas even if grafting is not done. If the farmers decide that grafting must be done because the soil's quality requires it, then the 3 to 4 feet long papayas plant is cut at the top. It should be noted that grafting can only be done when papaya plants have a rigid structure. Once the top is cut, the distinctive V-shaped is cut onto the top. That makes an anchorage point for another papaya plant that will fit into the V-shaped space. Once it's done, another papaya plant from another field, thus having different qualities, is combined. To do that, the lower end of the plant is made sharp, like the protruding V-shape that will fit into the space we created earlier. Once that's done, the two papayas plants are connected by putting pressure on the top plant being connected. A strong string or thread is wound around the area where grafting has been done so that the two plants don't fall off. Now, they will grow together, becoming one plant but having the qualities of two different papayas plants. After 5 to 6 months of doing this, papaya plants will grow into trees and little papayas will be visible. Farmers ensure that these little papayas get enough nutrients to grow into larger ones. Therefore, pesticides and bactericides are sprayed using vehicles with a large round-shaped sprayer. This sprayer sprays pesticides from all directions, thus ensuring that no plants miss it. And after 7 to 10 months from planting, the papayas will grow and be ready to be harvested. That's when the harvesting period starts, which is rather interesting. Instead of using machines, workers prefer picking fresh papayas using their hands. However, they cannot carry the papayas they are plucking from the trees. For obvious reasons, workers have devised a trolley and distribution network that eases the papayas transportation within the fields. Each worker uses a large trolley that has wheels. Papayas are picked and placed into that trolley throughout the fields. Once the trolley is filled with papayas, it's connected to the four strings of the infield distribution network. Interestingly, this network does not use machines, rather, it's quite a mechanical process. Workers install a cable trolley system with strings where the trolleys of papayas can be mounted. Queues of these trolleys are mounted on this cable trolley system, and the workers push these queues to take papayas out of the fields. This cable trolley system is rather crucial for the farmers because they have to carry papayas alone without it. Large buckets would be carried on the backs, slowing down the process. Farmers can also not use vehicles because these vehicles cannot go inside the papaya fields. That's why the cable trolley system has become too significant. In some cases, the two ends of the cable trolley system are kept different in height. The end in the fields is at a higher height than the end at the collecting site. This ensures that the workers don't have to push the trolleys, rather, they move by themselves due to their weight. It should be noted that farmers don't use machines inside the fields because they believe they can ruin the natural growth phase. Everything is done traditionally in the fields, without using any automatic machinery. When these papayas reach the next point, they are washed well and packed into wooden boxes. They are wrapped into plastic foam if they are sent to far-off places. At the same time, the remaining papayas are sent to the factories where further processing will be done. If you like to eat papayas, you will get the wooden boxes these workers have just made. However, if you like papaya juice or other products made from it, then you have to know how the processing is done. Papayas are washed when they reach factories and then sent to the automatic pressers. Every falling papaya is pressed, and juice and nectar come out at the bottom, collected in large metal containers. The pressing is done in such a way that the skin is peeled off while the internal edible part is collected. Seeds from the nectar are removed while the remaining juice is packed. If you don't know where papaya juice is used, you should know it runs an entire health industry. Various factories sell packed juices of fresh fruits and vegetables, which health and fitness lovers buy. The reason why papaya juice is loved is due to its health benefits. It induces weight loss, improves immunity and vision, fights cancer, prevents stress, and removes dead skin cells. Even it lowers inflammation and gives a fresh look to the skin. Did you know that papayas grow on trees, unlike money? Jokes aside, usually, people think papayas grow like watermelons and vines. But that's not the case. Have you ever tried grafting to make new varieties of vegetables and fruits? Comment right below in the comment section, should these farmers bring heavy machines to harvest papayas instead of hand-picking them? Do you want to watch more videos like this one? If yes, please like and share the video and subscribe to get more videos on technological feats and farming advancements that are changing the world. Until the next video, stay tuned.